can confirm that my screen is showing. That should be
see
good. Okay. I was so good to borrow your nice logo for this new session, Power Break. It's really cool. And I don't know if you know the other logo on the right side, the big one. It's actually from the MBAS. So the conference. It was the T-shirt contest, the winning contest. It's actually going to a conference. That was actually the start of this session. Because I went to the Power Platform Summit in Amsterdam last year, and one of the sessions there was the Microsoft Power Series, in which the Microsoft team provides deep dive content and hands-on workshop, for example. And one of those workshops was performance tuning, deep dive, and administration. And I attended that that workshop, and they started with some theory, and in the second half of the workshop they Charles Sterling started a quiz where we, as the attendees, had to answer questions about Power BI governance, for example, and administration topics. And the first one from the attendees with the right answer was allowed to demo it on stage, and also got points for that question awarded. And to keep the score, Charles used the Power Apps visual inside a Power BI report to keep the score of the attendee, so he entered the name and the score of that attendee. So that was the actually the reason I started this. It started as a blog post, and I worked it out as a presentation and a session also. So a little bit about me. I work at Van Lanschot Kempen. That's a wealth manager in the Netherlands, so a specialist bank. I'm the lead expert at the data management team. We make sure all the data in the bank is incorporated in our corporate data warehouse every day. And next to that, I'm also the Power BI administrator and governor, making sure the adoption of Power BI is going smoothly. And next to that, I'm also very active online. I blog a lot. I'm on Twitter, and I'm also active as a super user on the Power BI forum starting this year. And together with Mark Lelyveld, I started the Dutch chapter of Power BI Days. One second, I have my my headphones stopped working. Okay, I'll check that later. So let's first go to the final solution of my presentation. This is actually what I would like to achieve. So I'd like to have a dashboard in Power BI with on the left side the Power Apps visual, and on the right side a visual on the report, where I can show the answers immediately. So I'm using three of the four Power Platform products, and I'm just going to go get through this. Is with a streaming dataset. I'm creating a flow in Power Automate, and then the Power Apps to enter the values. And from that streaming dataset, I'm creating a report and a dashboard. And the dashboard is critical for updating my values in real time. So when I enter the values in the Power Apps and pushing a save on the button, then the screen automatically refreshes. So that's only available in the dashboard in Power BI. As this is a fairly short session, I have some parts prepared, and others I will show you in detail. And as Catherine said, also the talk is recorded, so you can watch it back. And you can also follow along with these two blog posts. They are on the Power BI community forum, so you can follow along on that also. So let's start over here. Yeah, I will put the links in the chat later. I'm sorry, I first have to quick check my headphones. That's better. Okay. Immediately. We have them here. Then we will go straight to the demos. So, as I said, I'm starting with a streaming data set in Power BI. So I'm in my workspace. You could start in any workspace, but I'm just using my workspace now, and I'm creating a streaming data set. I'm using the API version for this, and I just have to enter my name, and I can enter values for the for every field that I need, and you can only choose from three data types right now, so a text number or datetime. For now, I'm just going to show you this one that I prepared earlier. So you can see I have three fields, date, name, and score. The date isn't purely necessary, but I added it for maybe filtering out some test values, for example, in my report that I entered earlier. And I have a name with data type text and a score with data type number. And lastly, it's important to make sure the historic data analysis is on. That ensures that you have the values in your data set available longer than a few minutes. Otherwise, the data set will clear out and it's a streaming, more of a real-time streaming data set. So it might be important with IoT, kind of things, but now we're using a data set that we want to have available a little bit longer. Okay, so we have our streaming data set, the demo Power Break. Then we're going to Power Automate, so to Flow, and we're going to create an instant flow because we're going to trigger it manually with the push-off button in Power Apps. So Power Apps will be the trigger. And after that, we're going to send the values to Power BI to a dataset. And that will be the streaming dataset that I just created. So from workspaces, I will need to choose my workspace. This is the name that I created, so demo Power Break. And the table will always be real-time data. That's just the name that that's given to the dataset. And after I select those three options, the fields on the dataset will already pop up. For date, I will just use a fixed date. You see now, that's just the value that's populated every time I run the flow. For name, I will create a field from Power Apps, so out add rows to a dataset underscore name. That's the value that I need to enter in Power Apps. And for the score also, I click again on see more and then create another field. So it's name and score that are connected to my streaming dataset. And then I could save it and I'll also test it here. I'm just going to go back to my flows now because I created one earlier. So it's a demo Power Break. It has the same fields in here. And I could test it here. I'm just going to perform the trigger here. So save and test it. And here are the two fields. So let's enter my own name and the value of 10. And it successfully started. Now let's check if it also entered the values. So we see Nikki 10 and the daytime. It's UTC, so that's minus two hours. That's good. Let's quickly create a report. Just check the name here and the score, that you can see that the value is also in the data set. So that's good. So we have a row of data that I just entered in the test flow. So this is working, that's good. Now, let's go to Power Apps. I prepared a little bit of a Power App before. I should just go here and say that I created a Canvas app from Blank. So you can also use templates that are displayed here. You get all sort of prepared steps and forms for you, but I just wanted to have a Canvas app from Blank. So that's what I did. And I created two text inputs for name and score, and a save button that doesn't do anything yet. But I'm going to connect my flow to this button. So I only edited the canvas a little bit and added the names, and also gave these a meaningful name over here on the tree view. So what I would like to do is go to action and then Power Automate. Let me connect my save button to the Power Automate I just created. So I will connect it with the demo power break. And that gives me this run method with the two columns I just created in the flow. So add rows to dataset name and score. So the first one I would need is the name. So that's name, and I want to get the text value. The second one is the score, the text output. Then I want to convert this to a value. If I look here, it's data type of number, because that's the data type I created in my streaming data set. And actually, let's close this one. This is actually everything that I need. I only need one closing parenthesis, and so that's it. Let's enter this one and let's save it for a second. And let's try to run it. So I'm going to run it here. And again, let's give a score of 5 now. And let's save it. Well, we saw something. We saw the Power App running. Let's go to my report. And refresh. And there it is. We have another row in my data set. Just entered a few minutes ago. And what I would like to have is a little bit nicer user interface, that if I click the save button, that my buttons are reset, because now the values are still in there. So if I want to have a name, let's give Catherine 10 points, then the values just stay in the text inputs. So we can do that by clicking on the save button and having the onSelect method again selected. So that's the one where we run the flow. And if you press Alt Enter, that's Shift Enter. So then you get a new line. It's not necessary, but it's just the formatting that's better. We want to reset the controls that we said earlier. Reset the name. Reset the score. Okay. Let's close this down. Do that again. Oh, the names are there right now. Let's, and we see that the entered values are gone, and now the hint text is coming back that we expected. And if we get again, and we see that the values are gone, so that's good. It's a little bit nicer, and let's now refresh this one. That's also good. We have all the values are there. Let's order by date. Then we can see the number of the values showing up. Let me delete the date for now here. Choose this one. So let's have the stack column chart. And what I like to do is to distinguish the values a little bit better, is have the name column also in the legend. That will give me different colors for every value. You could also do it with this one. No. There's one that instantly creates the this one. Oh, but this one also has the legend. Yeah, so that's the same. So what that's what I like to do. Just give every value, every value in the dataset, so every name, a different color. And if I add more, then they will get a different color by default. So I created my Power App. So what I would like to do is add my Power Apps visual. How to get started? Well, you select some fields from your dataset that you would like to use in your Power App. So that would be name and scroll. And then I can create a new Power Apps, or I choose one that I already created, and it will connect it with this visual. So that's what I'm going to do here. So it's the demo power break. And I will click add. So the app is already here, but there's one thing we have to do. I'll go to the Power App Studio. Because it's still there, I did save it, so that's good. Let's close this down. And opening it in Power App Studio now will create a Power BI integration artifact. Yes, inside the Power Apps, so it's over here, and that will make sure that my connection between Power Apps and Power BI runs smoothly. So that's one thing you have to do inside of Power BI. I do have it saved but unpublished. So let's go here to publish. If you go to settings, for example, you can change all kinds of things. So the color and the icon of the visual or the screen size. So I made it a custom size or other settings that you want to change. So let's publish it. And then go back to Power BI. This is good. Yeah, published. Okay. So now if I enter values here, let's first save this one. Sure, well, I have here ones. All the way around. You can also create it in Power BI Desktop if you want. That's also fine. I just created it here. It's because it's so let's see. Let's give me 3 points now. Clicking save. Well, that will actually do nothing because this is still a report and I still have to refresh this, and then it will show up. So the important part now is getting it into my dashboard. Let's see, I think there's already one there. Let's create another one. Yes, and also my Power Apps visual. Power Bank demo, that's the one. So, pin it. Good click there. So, this is the one, Power Bank demo, I just added. Let's put the app on the left side. The visual here on the right side. And if we now enter some scores here, so let's. Then we will see that the updates are instantaneously. So we have a live dashboard. We can also add the course, for example. It will be here in 2 weeks. Let's give them some more points to make them happy. And we see that another color will also be added automatically. So add some other ones. And you can see that every time you add a new name, the colors will be chosen. I'm not sure if it is random. You can also add a team if you want, for example, then you have predefined colors. And let's say, for example, that you make a mistake. I want to give myself 10 points, but I accidentally say 100. Then 100 points will be added, but I could also say, well, it was actually 90 too much, so I will subtract. And it also works. So now I have 10 more than I originally had. There's just one thing. Let's see, I have 34 points now. So what happens if I extract 34 points, then I will have 0 points, but my name will still be in the data set. So I will have actually 0 points, but you can't get a name out of the data set. And you can also have negative points if you want. You can also go below zero. That's also possible. So that was the integration with Power Apps inside the Power BI dashboard and using Flow to automate it. I have a few slides left. Just some. Yeah.
We have some questions. Would you like to answer them at the end or now?
I think I have two or three slides left. So
okay, good. Then we will wait.
Yeah, I'll finish up and then we can do the questions. Yeah. When I first set this up, the blog post especially, I found some solutions to reset the controls. And also to set variables, for example, to show a text if you press the button and then let it disappear again. And actually using set is much easier than using update context. I used it and I showed that in my blog, so you can read about it there. So set is much easier than update context. Now, as I said, you can't delete a name. And I'm not sure if there are more Power BI administrators in the room, but there's something called a data loss prevention policy. It's added at the Power Platform Admin Center. Let me show that. So it's admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. And there's something called data policies. And we have a data policy, for example. You have three buckets. Two usable buckets. You have a business bucket and a non-business bucket, and also a blocked, so you can't use them at all. But when you want to build a solution, you have to make sure that all the connectors that you use are in the same bucket. So, for example, the business bucket, all Microsoft connectors inside, so Forms, Teams, Power Automate, Flow, Power BI, that sort of connector, SQL Server also. That's premium, but you can also add that. And the non-business, for example, Twitter or Facebook or RSS feeds. So these are all in the non-business bucket at our policy. And that means I can't use a Twitter connector then I also want to use Power BI, for example, or Power Apps. And you can change it, but it's just something you have to think about. And you will get an error message in your on your flow saying your policy prevents you from using these connectors in the solution. And then you could check with your admin if this is the case. Then you know where to look for. Yeah, and my last question actually to you is if you can think of any live or otherwise integrated dashboards or solutions that you can use from the Power Platform. So I believe you have some questions already. So
yes, I can read it for you. So we have them in the chat. First, is this available in Power BI Premium only?
No, it's not Power BI Premium. It's Power BI. You can actually use a free license, I believe, because you can create a streaming data set in your own workspace. I'm not sure about the licenses for Flow or Power Automate and Power Apps. I think you have you need a per Flow license for this. So you have you can license Power Automate per Flow or per user. And you need any one of those. I think you can also use a trial license to set this up. Mm-hmm. And depending on the other connectors, for example, I showed the SQL Server connector in here. So if you want to get data or write back data to a SQL Server database, that's a premium connector. So you have to pay extra for that connector. But the other ones, the standard ones, are free to use. You just need a Flow license for that, or a Power Apps license if you use those. So depending on what products of the Power Platform you use, you still need licenses for the other ones. But it's not Power BI Premium product. That's not necessary.
Okay. Thank you. Then we have also a question from Fernando. Maybe you like to ask Nikki themselves, so please.
Yeah, that's also possible.
Yes, thank you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, it's very brief. When you enter data in the Power Apps in the dashboard, it doesn't reset after saving.
What do you mean exactly?
After saving, sending the name and score in Power Apps in the dashboard, the fields don't reset.
Is that that's true indeed. That's a good one.
That's because it's a live demo.
Yes.
Let me try it here. That's a good one. All right, that's strange. Let me see if the reset was gone. So I think I didn't save it before closing it here and connecting it to Power BI. So that's a good catch. So I'll add them again. Yeah, thanks. Any other questions?
Well, yes, it's me again. And when you have a dashboard with streaming data set, are you allowed to make measures to compare the values with certain target and report a KPI with a variance?
You can create measures, but you can't add other data sources. So you're not able to connect it to another data source, for example. But I did create some measures, for example, on this one.
But if we want on our horizontal line in 10, everyone who exceeds 10 So yeah, we have a certain measure, no?
Depending on the type of visual, you can do that. Let's look over here. It's not best practice to add that or create or put in the service, but I'm still going to do it. If my Power BI desktop opens up, then I'll go there. But if you go to the analytics tab, okay, over here you can add a constant line, for example. So give it a value of 10. Make it stand out. So make it red, for example. Change the transparency. Oh, other way around. So that could be a constant line. If you want something that's that needs to change with your data, I don't think that's possible. But constant lines you can add easily. You can also add the data label, so that's also possible.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem. And if we briefly look at this Power BI desktop that I opened, this one was actually for the user group in Milan, I see. I have some meshes over here. For example, if I look at the details here, this is one of the strings that I get back from the streaming data set. It's actually a form in Microsoft Forms that I sent through a streaming data set. And these are the values that that are answered. So it's a multiple choice question, and people can also answer or select multiple answers. This is the measure that I use. So I'm using the contains string on the experience field to see if apps is used. So apps is then for Power Apps. And then this value counts towards the sum of my Power Apps value. So that I know, let's minimize this. I'm on the wrong page. So that I know how many people answered these values. So Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI. So three people answered Power Automate, three people, the other three also, and 14 or 13 answered Power BI. So you can do some basic measures if you have a streaming data set, but nothing real fancy or doing something with another data set or data source connected from somewhere else. So there's some basic editing that you can do.
Okay. Thank you, Nicky. I have your other questions.
Yeah.
Feel free to ask or to answer Nicky's question.
That's also possible. I will look to the chat. Oh yeah, okay, that's also. Okay, are there any use cases that you can think of? Have you used some of the products together, for example?
I must say that's very funny because I use this in my DIADS, but not with Power Apps. So I use Forms for my, for the data who can attendees put in my live streaming data set. So yes, so they can't change the data, but I think it's also really cool because Forms is relatively easy to set up. So you can go to Forms, create a form, and you can share the link and connect it also with the Power BI streaming data set.
Yeah, correct. And that's Forms is even easier to set up than a Power App, indeed. Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah, right. Yeah, so that's my use case. So I use it in real in my DIAD presentations, and it's really funny. So, and the people are always amazed about this, how this can go, and how do you use it, or do you do this? And it's really cool.
Yeah, correct. I can tell you one example that we are using at our company also. So it's the one that's on this blog post by Shabnam Watson. She's talking about write back in Power BI reports. So you can use a Power App as I did in a Power BI report, but then you, instead of connecting it with a flow to your streaming dataset, you can connect it to a SQL Server database. And that can be the same database that you are using in the report. So you're using a dataset to connect to for your report, and you want to change or add some data to the dataset using Power Apps. So you can create a Power App to connect to that same dataset in SQL Server, and then add rows to your data, for example, or change rows. That's also possible to have it update by the user or by the key, the Power users. That's up to you who you give rights to the report and the app. So that's a common scenario of using write-back in Power BI to update values of in your report, for example.
Yes, but I think it's a little bit expensive if you use SQL Server with Power Apps. So it depends on your plans you have with licensing.
Yeah, that's correct. As I mentioned, SQL Server is a premium connector, so that's that's right. A little pricier than using a standard connector.
Right. So yes, have we other questions? Otherwise, I think we can finish our power break, our first power break, and I can stop the recording. So.